nor destruction within thy borders. But thou shalt be called, this is your name, that thou shalt be thy wall, that thou shalt call thy walls salvation and thy gates praise. New name, salvation. New name, praise. The sun shall no more be thy light by day, neither the brightness of the moon give, neither shall the moon give light unto thee, but the Lord shall be unto thee an everlasting light, and thy God thy glory. Thy sun shall no more go down, neither shall thy moon withdraw itself, for the Lord shall be an everlasting light, and the days of thy mourning shall be ended. Thy people also shall all be righteous. They shall inherit the land forever. The branch of my planting, the work of my hands, that I may be glorified. A little one shall become a thousand. Something is happening this year.
Amen.
Glorious things are happening this year.
Amen.
Expansion.
Amen.
Enlargement.
Amen.
Extension.
Amen.
And God will make your roots go deep. Will make your branches go high.
Amen.
Fruits in every family.
Amen.
Joy in every life.
Amen.
Because it says a little one shall become a thousand, and a small one a strong nation. I, the Lord, will hasten it in his time. What does that mean? What does that mean? Wait, what does that mean? I, the Lord, will hasten it. It will start in January. Your blessings are not waiting till March or April or November or December. I, the Lord, will hasten it. It will do it in Jesus' name. You are even going to carry part of the blessing home today. Because the Lord says it will hasten it. It will perform it in Jesus' name. And isn't it wonderful? The Lord says this is a new year. You are going to be a new man. And then you are going to have a new name. I have a new name. I said I have a new name. Let me tell you the name. Number one, you're a son. Number two, you're sheep. Number three, you're saint. Number four, you're sword. Number five, you're soldier. Number six, you're servant. Number seven, you have become a star. Number one, son. Let's look at Romans chapter 8. Romans chapter 8, the new name. The new name that the Lord is giving everyone that comes to the Lord. As newborn babes in Christ, you are born again, you are a child of God. You are turned away from sin and you turn to the Savior. And he says, I give you a new name. You are no more an enemy. You are no more an outsider. You are a son to the Father in Jesus' name. And then we read in that passage, Romans chapter 8 verse 14, for as many as are led by the Spirit of God, they are the sons of God. They are the sons of God. For ye have not received the spirit of bondage again to fear, but ye have received the spirit of adoption, whereby we cry, Abba, Father. And the Spirit itself beareth witness with our spirit that we are the children of God. And if children, then heirs, heirs of God, and joint heir with Christ. If so be that we suffer with him, that we might also be glorified with him. It says, now we have new names and we are sons. And because we are sons, we are inheriting. Everything that belongs to the Father belongs to you. And all the joy you need, all the health you need, all the holiness you need, all the provision you need, all the prosperity you need, everything is available for you this year. And from this day, you'll begin to enjoy them. Number one, we're sons. Number two, we're sheep. We're looking at John chapter 10. John chapter 10, and I'm reading there from verse 2 to verse 5. John chapter 10, verse 2. But he that entereth in by the door is the shepherd of the sheep. To him the porter openeth, and the sheep hear his voice. This year, you will not be stubborn goats. You will be a following sheep in Jesus' name. The sheep hear his voice, and he calleth his own sheep by name, and leadeth them out. And when he putteth forth his own sheep, he goeth before them, and the sheep follow him, for they know his voice. The Lord says the goats do not belong to him. If you find anybody that is like a goat, heady, stiff necked, stubborn, hard hearted, that's not of God. Those ones do not belong to the Lord. They are deceiving themselves and they think they are saved. If somebody is heady, incorrigible, stubborn, stiff necked, he that has been often reproved and hardness his neck shall suddenly be destroyed, and that without remedy. He doesn't have a redeemer. But the people of the Lord have a new name, and the name is son, and the name is sheep. And he says, my sheep hear my voice, and they follow me. And he says in verse 5, and a stranger will they not follow, but they will flee from the stranger, for they know not the voice of strangers. We're looking at verse 27. My sheep hear my voice, and I know them, and they follow me. They follow me. The sheep, they follow the shepherd. They follow the Lord. They follow the word of the shepherd, the word of scripture. In verse 28, and I give unto them eternal life, and they shall never perish. As the sheep are following the Lord, we will not perish. You will not perish. I will not perish. We will not perish. I will help you with the scriptures this year to make sure you will not perish. You will help me with your response to my preaching to make sure I will not perish. You will not perish. Your family will not perish. The work of your hand will not perish. The seed you sow, you will reap that seed. And your ministry will not perish in Jesus' name. And I, your pastor, I will not perish. Your behavior, your character will not make me perish. You will not give me hypertension. You will not make me angry. You will not provoke me. You'll make me to go from strength to strength. As I develop you, you'll develop me. As I make you happy, you'll make me happy. And as I'm saying to it, that you, not nobody, will touch your life. As I'm saying to that, you too, you'll see to that, that nothing will touch my life. And hand in hand, hand in hand, hand in hand together, we'll get to heaven together. I give unto them eternal life, and they shall never perish, neither shall any man blot them out of my hand. Anytime this year you get into any trouble, just say, you know, the following Sunday, you know, you run there to the church, and if your coordinator, your group coordinator is not available, not able to help you, you run here, I'll be waiting for you at the gate. Because this year nobody will pluck you out of the hand of the Lord. And all the blessings the Lord is going to hasten up to give to you, I'll make sure they are preserved in your life. In verse 29, my Father which gave them to me is greater than all, and no man, everybody say no man, no man is able to pluck them out of my Father's hand. My Father and I and my Father are one. Number one, you are son. Number two, you are sheep. Number three, you are saint. Saint. Ephesians chapter 5. Ephesians chapter 5, I'm reading from verse 1. Ephesians chapter 5, we're looking at verse 1. Be ye therefore followers of God as their children, and walk in love as Christ also has loved us, and has given himself for us, an offering and a sacrifice to God for a sweet smelling savor. But fornication, God forbid. I said, God forbid. And all uncleanness, God forbid. And covetousness, Did he hear you? Let it not be once named among you as becometh saints. This year, you will not be a sinner. You will be a saint in Jesus' name. Number four, you are salt. Matthew chapter 5. Matthew chapter 5, we're reading from verse 13. Matthew chapter 5, we're reading from verse 13. Matthew 5, verse 13. Ye are the salt of the earth. This year, you will be sweet. Ye are the salt of the earth, but if the salt have lost its savor, you are not going to lose your savor. When we shall be salted, it is not for good for nothing, but to be cast out and to be trodden under the foot of men. We are salt this year. Everywhere we turn in all our districts, our coordinators will be sweet. Our group coordinators will be sweet. Our counselors, when they come to counsel us, they'll be sweet in Jesus' name. This year will not be afraid of the marriage committee. Marriage committee will be sweet. They will be sweet. Go to them, go to them. Maybe you even want to go to them today after the service. Go to them. They will smile at you. They will say welcome. All the marriage committee this year, what are they?
Sweet.
They will be sweet. Don't be afraid of them. And then they will speed up the blessing of your marriage this year in Jesus' name. And then, you know, those sisters, you know, sometimes that brother, I understand what you are thinking about now. I spoke to that sister last year. That was last year. Come on now. Come on to the new year. Everybody say, new year.
Yeah.
And then, you know, when you spoke to that sister last year, she said, what do you mean? Coming to me. And she was sour. Go back to her. She'll be sweet. Praise the Lord. Because this year we're not going to be sour to anybody. This year we're going to be sweet. And you wear a smile everywhere you go. And you touch another person's life. Even if you say it's not the will of God, say it in a sweet way that the brother will not be discouraged. And then, sister, if you know the will of God to a man, don't hide somewhere. Come out and say, hey, come on here. What do you want to say? You're a lady, you're a woman. The pastor said, I shall come to you. And the pastor said, I shall talk to you. That I know that you are the will of God for me. And the brother will not be sour. He will be sweet. This year there's sweetness in our church. I said there's sweetness in our church. I'm going to tell you a secret. They said, other people, they said, deeper life. They have doctrine. They don't have love. Did you hear that before? We must change that accusation. We have doctrine, we also have love. This year, there's love in this church. Our new name is Salt. And we're going to be sweet to everybody. You touch my life and you put sweetness in my life. I come to the service, I come to the Bible study, I look at you like this, you are waving at me, Pastor, I'm going to put some sweetness in your life at the Bible study. You'll not put anything sour in my life in Jesus' name. Yeah. Nobody will put sand in my garri. Yeah. How about you? This year is another year.
Yeah.
Praise the Lord! S for soldier. We're looking at 2 Timothy, 2 Timothy chapter 2. 2 Timothy chapter 2 verse 3. Now therefore, endure hardness as a good soldier of Jesus Christ. You'll be a soldier. Then we're servants of the Lord in Romans chapter 6. Romans chapter 6. And we're looking at verse 22. Romans chapter 6. Verse 22. But now be made free from sin. And become servants to God. Ye have your fruit unto holiness, and the end everlasting life. And then, number seven. I said, who are you? I said, what are you? I said, what are you going to become? You will be a star. Look at Daniel chapter 12 verse 3. Daniel chapter 12 verse 3. And they that be wise shall shine as the brightness of the firmament, and they that turn many to righteousness as the stars forever and ever. Praise the Lord. I said, praise the Lord. You know, anywhere I go this year and any office I get to, I'm going to find a deeper life person there. And then the director there and the managers there, they're going to say, you know, Pastor, there's something we discovered that your members who are in this, our office, all of a sudden this year, we don't know. They're just the people at the top, they're the head and they're not the tail. And they have become the stars in every corporation, every company, every school. All our students in our, this year, they're going to be stars in their colleges. And stars in their schools. There is no failure in deeper life this year. And you know, if there's any failure in your life, after the service, I'll be waiting at the back there to counsel. Come and report that thing to me. I will yank it out of your life. And you'll become a star in Jesus' name. Amen. Good. Amen. Point number two, the new nature of the new man. The new nature of the new man. We're looking at Ephesians chapter 2, reading from verse 1. New nature that the Lord is giving us this new year. A turning around, a change, a transformation. That the Lord says, I want everything new in your life in this new year. And that new nature the Lord is going to give unto us. He gives us a new mind, a new heart, a new spirit, a new attitude, and everything within us just becomes totally new, that nothing of the old nature will remain in any of us in Jesus. Ephesians chapter 2 verse 1. And you will see quickened who are dead in trespasses and sins, wherein in time past you walked according to the course of this world, according to according to the prince of the power of the air, the spirit that now walketh in the children of disobedience, among whom also we all had a conversation in times past, in the lust of our flesh, and fulfilling the desires of the flesh and of the mind, and were by nature the children of wrath, even as others. But now he says, he has quickened us. He has made us alive. He has turned us around. He has changed everything. That means that the new nature has now come. I said the divine nature has now come. Beautiful nature, righteous nature, holy nature, divine nature, the very nature of God, a godly nature. In 2 Peter chapter 1 verse 3. According as his divine power, he has given unto us, how many things? He has given unto us all things that pertain unto life and godliness through the knowledge of him that has called us to glory and to virtue. This year he has not called us to vice, he has called us to glory and to virtue. He has not called us to disgrace, he has called us to glory and to virtue. He has not called us to failure, he has called us to glory and to virtue. He has not called us to defilement, sin, evil, fornication, adultery. He has called us to glory and to virtue, whereby are given unto us exceeding great and precious promises, that by these ye might be partakers of what? Of the divine nature. That's the new nature. The new nature of the believer. Anytime you want to do anything this year, you must ask yourself, is this the nature of God? And you know the way some people, the way they talk. You know, somebody gets angry and furious. I say, what are you doing? How can you be that angry? Look at your eyes, they are red. And look at you trembling with anger. Hey, don't blame me. That's how my daddy used to be. My daddy will not be like that. That's my nature. My nature will not be like that. I said your nature will not be like that. Nature of anger. Nature of bitterness. Nature of being morose and sad and sorrowful. No joy. Our nature will change this year in Jesus' name. He has given us a divine nature, that by this he might be partakers of the divine nature, having escaped the corruption that is in the world through lust. With that divine nature, he has made us, number one, a new creature. Number two, he has given us a new heart. Number three, he has put within us a new spirit. Number four, he has given us a new covenant. Number five, he's giving us a new tongue. Number six, he's giving us new commandments. Number seven, we become a new law. That's a new man. That's a new nature. That you reveal what it means to be new. A new creature. A new heart. A new spirit. With a new covenant.